Current limitation is a function of how quickly the fuse can react to a fault and clear it before the fault current can build up to destructive levels. NEC 240.2 defines a current limiting device as a device that, when interrupting currents in its current limiting range, reduces the current flowing in the faulted circuit to a magnitude substantially less than that obtainable in the same circuit if the device were replaced with a solid conductor having comparable impedance. Fuses that limit the let-through current to downstream components provide protection from thermal and magnetic forces while providing numerous benefits. Current limiting fuses enhance workplace safety by reducing the incident energy personnel are exposed to under fault conditions. Arc flash hazards may be greatly reduced when compared to using a non-current limiting overcurrent protective device, especially at 600 amps and below. Fuses can protect components and equipment from extreme thermal and magnetic forces by clearing the fault current within the first half or quarter cycle. Conductors, busway, motor starters, switches, and other devices can be well protected with current limiting fuses. Fuse current limitation helps equipment achieve high short circuit current ratings. Branch circuit components inside industrial control panels and machines, HVAC control panels, and other UL 508A listed equipment can be protected by current limiting fuses in the feeder circuit. The low peak let through can help raise the overall equipment short circuit current rating, even with lower rated devices in the branch circuit, as long as the peak let through current is less than the branch circuit component's short circuit current rating and the branch circuit overcurrent protected device's interrupting rating is sufficient. Current limitation is a key part of selective coordination, and current limiting fuses save the engineer or designer time and money by reducing the need for a selective coordination study, as long as the minimum amp ratio is maintained between upstream and downstream fuses, such as a 2-to-1 amp rating ratio for Bussmann series low peak fuses. Selective coordination is achieved and unnecessary power loss to upstream circuits is prevented to any fault current up to the interrupting rating of the fuse. Protecting electrical system components from fault currents is critical when selecting overcurrent protective devices. The engineer or specifier should consider the electrical circuit components SCCR, such as wire, bus, or motor starters, and whether proper circuit protection will improve reliability and reduce the possibility of injury. Electrical systems can be destroyed if overcurrent protective devices do not limit the fault current to within the system's component short circuit current rating. Merely matching the component amp rating with the protected device amp rating does not ensure component protection under fault conditions. A non-current limiting overcurrent protected device permits fault current to build up to its full value and lets through an immense amount of destructive current, heat, and magnetic energy before opening. Some overcurrent protected devices will permit short circuit currents to flow for more than one cycle. The shaded area under the curve represents the energy being dissipated in the circuit, with both magnetic forces and thermal energy being directly proportional to the square of the current, making it important to limit the short circuit current to as small a value as possible. The maximum magnetic forces vary as the square of the peak current, and the thermal energy varies as the square of the RMS current. This waveform demonstrates this same short circuit when the fuse operates within its current limiting range. A current limiting fuse has such a fast response speed that it cuts off the current long before it can build up to its full peak value. In the first major fault current cycle depicted by the waveform, a non-current limiting overcurrent protective device would let through approximately 100 times as much destructive energy as a current limiting fuse. This is assuming an asymmetrical peak current of 100,000 amps and a peak let-through current of 10,000 amps. Modern fuse designs are current limiting and greatly reduce a fault current's destructive peak and duration to protect downstream equipment. This can reduce the bracing needs for bus structures and minimize the need for components to have high short circuit current ratings or withstand ratings. If not limited, destructive faults can reach levels of 30,000 amps or higher, even up to 200,000 amps in the first half cycle, which is approximately 8 milliseconds. The immense heat that can be produced in circuit components can cause conductor insulation damage or violent component explosions. At the same time, huge magnetic forces developed between conductors can crack insulators and destroy bracing structures, with the maximum mechanical force exerted being proportional to the square of the instantaneous peak current. It is extremely important that overcurrent protective devices limit fault currents before they reach their full potential.